My name is Kiyoshi Sho. This is Sensei Kwame. We are from Temple of Nemesis Jiu-Jitsu and Eagle Star Ryu Jiu-Jitsu. I'm just going to show you guys a basic flowing technique of a basic grab that you can also use for also from a punching position. Excuse me. So what happens is your assailant comes and he puts his hand up on you, right? So what you do as the counter to this is not pull away, run away, whatever the case may be, right? So what happens is they give to you, you give to them. So you have to give way. So what happens when he touches, I take and give way, right? Hitting right underneath the ear bone, okay? So when he touches, let go, touch again. One, two, hit in, raise up, pull down, okay? I'm gonna hit to the, brachii muscle in the forearm. I'm gonna hit hard into here. You see how his body comes into me? So when I hit and pull this in, I'm gonna switch positions. Bang, and hit immediately. I'm gonna take the hand that's on me and I'm gonna grab the thumb nodule and I'm gonna just turn it out. See how that turns out to you? I'm gonna get right from there, just turn that right out. From there, I'm gonna reach up underneath and just give a nice tight hug. Reach up over the top, and all I'm gonna very gently do, because it's my partner, I don't wanna hurt his shoulder and wrist, just he takes his head, he tucks down, and he's just gonna turn down and fall straight down to the floor. And I allow my partner to fall without sustaining serious shoulder injury. I'm gonna show you that again. So, touches, one, two, strike. Turn, kotegaish, reach up underneath and wrap the kotegaish. This is basically kotegaish makikomi. All I'm gonna do is take the hands and push straight down into my opponent and fall straight down to the floor. If you did this technique fast, your partner will sustain wrist and shoulder injury. So when you do techniques like this, make sure you take the time to allow your partner to get around. So he touches. So one, turn, lock, and I slow it down right there because I don't want him to get hurt. Okay, come again. Let me show you from the opposite side so you guys can see what this looks like as well. So when he touches, pull, draw, pull, strike right across. See, his hand is right there, ready for me to just turn out. Take my free hand as I step to the inside, reach up underneath the elbow, reach back and grab the hand. So the hand that grabs me first with the kotegaish turns it out. So that way my left side of the body and my right side of the body equally have jobs to do. So this hand will turn out, the other hand will reach at the same time, make prayer hands and take straight down to the floor. When that happens, I would hold this crank position and straighten this arm out by locking his head down so he couldn't move. And I would take this arm in the circular motion, lock it out, and push down on the elbow, hyperextending the elbow and jacking the wrist. So he touches. One, two, turn, lock. Give him a chance to get down, lock, hyperextend the wrist, okay? Remember, turn, hyperextend the wrist, hyperextend the elbow. You would really just snap this and break that really quickly. You can also finish this if you need it to be more secure. Grab the hand as it's turned and just step into him, and I've got a nice kotegaish from the bottom. He can't turn because I've got his head locked out. Okay, remember, always two-hand techniques. Don't get cocky doing this one-hand stuff. Two-hand technique can hold him nice and tight. Okay? This is a technique that I just want to share with you guys. Enjoy. If you have any questions, comments, hit me up. Please feel free to share us a comment. Let us know what you think.